हेलो नमस्कार एंड आदाब टू ऑल माय फ्रेंड्स फ्रॉम योर फ्रेंड एस्ट्रोलॉजर एंड गाइड इरफान वंस मोर विथ यू फ्रॉम योर वेरी ओन चैनल एस्ट्रो एश्योरेंस। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक टू यू अबाउट अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट योगा योगा विच इज कॉल्ड द आदि योगा। दिस इज वन ऑफ दोज योगाज विच इज नॉट एज मच डिस्कस्ड दो इट्स अ पावरफुल योगा बट द प्रेजेंस ऑफ द योगा इज ईदर नॉट आइडेंटिफाइड ईजिली बिकॉज ऑफ टू सम एक्सटेंट इग्नोरेंस और the other could be that people don't focus on the presence of this yoga so much because the focus is more on the more popular yogas like the Gajkesari yoga or the Lakshmi yoga, the Saraswati yoga or the Guru Chandal yoga or the Shapit dosha and the other doshas. So sometimes this dosha gets missed and for identification, and I would not blame the astrologers alone for missing the identification of the doshas, because there are too much pressure on the poor astrologer also, because many times people identify their own yogas by using some software, online software, and then they come and ask the astrologer, why is my Buddha Ditya yoga not functioning, why is my Gajkesari yoga not functioning, and so on. So the astrologer, poor astrologer, sometimes is too focused on the more popular yogas, and some of the other very powerful yogas which can be as strong if not more get missed out for either identification or explanation that the person has this yoga. So I want to focus on the Adi yoga because it's a very very important yoga, and if somebody has this yoga then the person's life could be a life of a lot of popularity, a lot of opulence, and one of the very important things, a reputation of being a nice guy. We all like to be known as the nice person, the nice guy. We want to be known as a wealthy person. We also want to be known as an intelligent person, a very learned person. But we also want to be known as the wise person, and more than everything else, we want to be known as the nice person. That this person is so nice, this person is so good, he's such a gentleman. Or a gentle lady. So this yoga, the Adi yoga, gives you the manifestation or the promise, or let me put it this way, rather than a promise, the potential to really be known as a nice guy, the nice person, and have a good reputation, have good opulence, and a person whom even the enemies or those people who are his contemporaries or those people who are his competition also may see the person as learned, respected, and very liked. So there would be very few people who may not like such a person. And when the person leaves the world, even the so-called people inimical to him or her will be forced to say nice things about the person, because they will truly miss the presence of such a person. So what is this Adi yoga? The Adi yoga is a yoga formed from the moon. Now, firstly, before I get into the explanation about Adi Yoga, why are so many yogas manifested from the moon or involving the moon? The simple reason being is, and I've made a video on this as well, that which is the most important planet in the horoscope? The most important planet in the horoscope is the moon. And so, because moon represents your heart and also is the manas, called the manas, which also means it is the mind, it is the brain behind the brain, and moon is the ruler of all opulence through the fourth house, because fourth house is the house of material benefits, all sorts of riches that you can have is from the fourth house, or is the fourth house. So moon is a very very important planet. It is also the mother. It's all emotions, domestic happiness, mental peace. So if you have a very strong fourth house and a strong lagna, more or less you are taken care of. So moon ruling the fourth house and representing so many things becomes a very very important planetary entity, because if the moon is not strong, then if the mind is not there, then who are you? So it is the mind which gives us the conscious. If you are not conscious, then we are unconscious. If you are unconscious, then are we living? And some famous writer has said it is the conscience which makes us conscious. So if you don't have a conscience, the heart, then are we truly living? Even if you are conscious, but if we don't have a conscience, we don't have a heart, which is a heart of empathy, of understanding, then are we truly living? So Adi Yoga gives you a combination of both. It makes you conscious and it gives you a conscience. So how does it form? Shloka say that the presence of the three benefics from the moon in the 6th, 7th or 8th house, either in one of them or all in one of them, but all the other three benefics should be in not any other house but these three houses, 6, 7, 8, either collectively in one house or spread over three houses, or in three of them in two houses, either 6 or 7 or 6 or 8 or 7 or 8 or any combination, but all the other three benefics, Jupiter, Mercury and Venus, all the three planets should be only in these three houses, 6, 7th and 8th, and not in any other house in the horoscope. Then the Adi Yoga is formed. Now, why are the 6th and the 8th house included in the Adi Yoga and the 7th house? 7th house is also called as the Maraka house. So, why is the 6th, 7th and 8th position or the placement of benefics important from the moon to give you Adi Yoga? Now, firstly, moon represents which sign? Moon represents the sign of Cancer. Which is the sign of the house 6th from Cancer? The 6th house from Cancer is Sagittarius. Sagittarius is the house of luck. This is the trine house or the trikona house, one of the most important houses for luck, fate. The house also of high learning, spirituality, and also theology or religion. In today's time, 9th house is also very important because it is also the house of long distance travel. And so, if you don't have a very strong 9th house, then it's not so easy to go to foreign lands or get benefit from the foreign lands. So, the 6th house from the Cancer sign, which is ruled by the moon, is Sagittarius, which represents your fate or luck. If you have a strong 6th house from the moon, then your fate or luck will have a strong dimension to it. The planets will favor you from time to time. You will find that you are lucky. You get, even if you meet with an accident, you barely miss the accident by a whisker. And you get away with small injuries, but not large damages. So, luck favors you if your 6th house is strong, especially from the moon. Now, the Lagna is also very important. However, the Lagna is more about your whole body and your whole personality. Moon is the mind, the thinking heart. So, why the thinking heart? Because your ability to think, coupled with your emotions and empathy, how you can understand and relate to the other person, together combined, only then you can overcome the strongest of strong opposition. And 6th house is the house of enemies. It is the house of competition. It is the house of overcoming competition. And so for those people who are sitting in competitive exams, 6th house becomes very important. It is also the house of service. It is also the house of documentation and loss of the relationship of the 7th, or even loss of business, because 7th house is also about business, partnership. So the 6th house from the moon is very, very critical. If you are able to overcome your enemies and nicely and make them your friends, get them to your side, what more do you want? So that's why very famous people have said you need to be closer to your enemies than to your friends. And so the Adi Yoga allows you, with three benefics in 6th, 7th and 8th house, to concentrate all your benefic abilities on these houses so that you can control the manifestation of these houses. So with a good benefic in the 6th house from the moon means you can use, you are lucky in using your mind and empathy and understanding in either handling your enemies well, overcoming your enemies, or destroying your enemies, or making friends of your enemies, so that the competition thinks twice before they manipulate anything wrong towards you, any trickery towards you, or putting you down in a very unethical and immoral fashion. And even if they do, it will be very difficult for them to face you and tell you and accept that, yes, yeah, I did this. They'll feel sorry, they'll feel bad when they do that because they know that you are a nice guy. So obviously, it won't be easy for people to, to deal with a nice guy, with unethical means. So this yoga allows you to be the nice guy, but you're not foolish, you're not stupid. So you are seen by others as a strong personality, a clever person, an intelligent person, but a nice person who will not use unethical means himself in spite of being very powerful, very learned and very influential. And so enemies will also salute you or respect you. And that's why the sixth house from the moon is one of the important placements for the Adi Yoga. The second placement is the seventh house. Now, normally the seventh house from the Lagna is the house of all others or dealing with others on a day-to-day basis or even partnerships. Now, what is the seventh house from Cancer? The seventh house from Cancer is Capricorn, the house of your karma. So when you combine dealing with others on a day-to-day basis with your karma and using your mind, your emotions, your empathy to do your karma very well and to show that you are a caring person, you are a thinking person, you are an understanding person at work, then it's easy to overcome people or handle people or manage people on a day-to-day basis. It is easy to do business, it is easy to get success, it is easy to do your karma, and it is easy to live your karma and shed your karmic debt. That's why a benefit from 7 from the moon is a very strong placement, because then you're combining relationships with karma. And if you are very strong in your relationship, then it is better, easier, and you can do your karma better. And that's why the 7th from the moon is very important. Now, normally the 8th from the Lagna is Scorpio, where moon gets debilitated. But what is the 8th sign from Cancer? The 8th sign from Cancer is Aquarius. Aquarius represents the larger world, the larger society, the extended society. And if you are popular in the extended society, if the extended society or most of the people see you as good, nice, capable, intelligent, influential, powerful, then what more do you want? People want to be associated with powerful people and nice, powerful people. People want to be closer to people who are influential, people who can think and who can understand and do things for them, do favors for them. And they can, you are known by the company you keep. So people want to be known as somebody who knows an influential person, an influential, nice person. For example, if somebody says, I knew APJ Abdul Kalam, who was a nice person, but he was a powerful person, a very acclaimed person, a very learned person, or maybe earlier Vikram Sarabhai, or in today's time, if somebody says that I know the an influential person and a powerful person or a nice person who is a Nobel laureate or the head of a state, say for example Justin Trudeau, who is the Prime Minister of Canada, then I'm just giving one example, depends on who you find to be good, clever, intelligent and powerful and influential today, then obviously your stake goes up as well. So that's why the 8th house from Cancer, Aquarius, the larger world, is important. But the 8th house from Cancer, which is Aquarius, is also a house and sign which represents meeting of your aspirations, getting your desires, meeting your aspirations, which means your desires get fulfilled, your aspirations are fulfilled. And so it is also an Upachaya house, which means it grows over a period of time. And if you use your mind, if you use your energies, if you use your empathy, if you use your friendships, if you use your influential power to influence and your wisdom well, then you can gain. You can spread your influence over a larger world, over a wide scope. And a lot of people with a strong Adi Yoga do very, very well working in large organizations, because they're seen as, for example, nice CEOs, humble MDs, or nice managing directors who are good people as well. So this is a good and powerful placement to have, with 6th, 7th and 8th house being powerful. Now, there are different manifestations on which planet gets into which house from the moon. For example, if the 6th from the moon has Mercury, then you will overcome your enemies by tact, by diplomacy, because the 6th house from the moon is the house of enemies, inimical forces, competition. And Mercury means you'll use tact, guile, you'll use diplomacy, and you use your cleverness, and you may use data or information to be able to subdue them, overcome them, handle them, or get them to your side. If Jupiter is in the 6th house from the moon, then you'll use wisdom and you'll use wise counsel, and you may even want to shake their hands, show statesmanship, and handle the person. if Venus is sixth from the moon, then you may be very soft, you may be very nice, you may be very gracious, you may shower gifts on them, you will give them more than their due share, and you get them over, you win them over with gifts, being nice, being gentlemanly, you being chivalrous, and being more kind-hearted, being more large-hearted. And so you overcome your competition through that. If Mercury is in the seventh from the moon, then you are able to handle your relationships with a lot of tact, with a lot of humility and a lot of diplomacy, and you will not hesitate to even bend a little bit as a matter of tact and diplomacy to win over the others, and through that you form relationships. With Jupiter in the seventh, you use wisdom to form relationships. You go out of the way to form relationship and long-lasting relationship, because you feel, if I earn more people, the people that I earn will earn money for me. On the other hand, if Venus is in the seventh house, then you'll use your charm. You may use your power of looks and how you are presenting yourself and what your reputation in society is, and your personality and your charm, to be able to manage relationships. So you work on relationships through your charm, through being nice, and over a period of time creating more friends. Sixth house is about overcoming enemies and trying to get them to your side. Seventh house is about making as many as friends and forming relationships, long-term relationships, which will help you in the long run. Whereas the eighth from the moon is about your karma and how you are able to use your karma and your influence and your relationships for larger benefits to society, and through that gain reputation, name, fame, money, everything. So in short, what does the Adi Yoga give you? The Adi Yoga, as I said, gives you name, reputation, affluence, power, potential, makes you the nice guy, helps you overcome enemies, and it also gives you lot of respect, adulation and love from people. So it's a mix of yoga. The only challenge that Adi Yoga presents in today's time is that the moment you use too much tact and guile, you spoil the Adi Yoga. And today's time, it is about as diplomatic as you can get, using as much guile as you can get. Today is the rage of Rahu, and so who has stronger Rahu probably would overcome somebody with a strong Adi Yoga. In earlier times, kings used to look at the horoscopes of the people who they make ministers. If a minister or a potential minister had a very strong placement to become a king, then the king would not select the person, because he had placements to become a king. He would probably dethrone the king himself and become the king. So they would use the knowledge of astrology or keep astrologers to find somebody who has a strong Adi Yoga, because the Adi Yoga person will handle the king's affairs for him. So he will be next in line to the ruler, but he will not be the ruler himself. So generally people with the Adi Yoga may not reach to the top position, like being a prime minister, being the head of state, or being a very powerful general. But they will be one lower level lower than the king, may not take the risks of the being the ruler, the prime minister and all, but be one level lower and be a powerful, an influential, a respected minister of the second in command. And through that, through the indirect means, they may be able to handle a lot of power and influence in today's society. And so that's why, while it may not allow you to reach the top like a Rahu or a Sun may be able to give you, however, the Adi Yoga is still very, very strong yoga, and it can give you an all-round life. It can give you a life of abundance, prosperity, happiness, respect, being liked, leaving a legacy of being a nice person, and enjoying a good family. What more do you want in life? Even if you don't reach the topmost position, one position lower, but being known as the nice guy and leaving a legacy of being somebody who's very respected. So that's very, very critical when you have the Adi Yoga and making your presence felt and leaving a good legacy behind. With other yogas where Rahu is powerful, or even Mars is powerful, Sun is powerful, you may still leave a legacy behind, but there will be many areas of your life which will be under dark clouds. People may say everything was good, but this particular thing wasn't so good. For example, if you mention Indira Gandhi, who won the 1971 war for us, she was also instrumental in the you know, taking over Siachen and many other, you know, places where she was able to score and have a standing for India. However, the emergency was also something which we will always remember as something which was challenging. So there are many people in every whose tenure there would be some blip, you know, that the person will have when the other yogas were more powerful. But a person with Adi Yoga will enjoy almost everything and a good reputation, unsullied reputation, and would enjoy power, influence, money, love, happiness. And this is a truly, as I call it, it's a mixed yoga from, it's a straddling of the two worlds. You know, living hundreds of years back, but also living today and being able to balance the life between the two. Being a wise person, being a nice person, being a powerful, influential person, and using your tact, diplomacy, mind, power, wisdom, and your grace to overcome enemies and get everybody your side, and then through that be able to leave your legacy behind and get what you want to achieve in life. So friend, this is my analysis about the Adi Yoga. This is an important yoga where all the three benefits are in your 6th house, or all three in your 7th house, or all three in your 8th house, or they are spread over 6th, 7th or 8th. But if you have such a placement, please utilize it to your advantage. And that's why it's important that I keep saying this, that you get your horoscope analyzed to know what yogas you have, what potential you have, or your children have, or your spouse has this, and be able to guide them towards the right direction, including guiding yourself or using the yogas to move in the right direction and getting the maximum out of the yoga and milking the yoga, as the term I use. So please like this video, please share this video, and please subscribe to my channel. If you're looking for a personal consultation from me, please reach out to me at the links given below. And till some other time that we meet, this is your friend, astrologer and guide Irfan, signing off. Ciao.